Well, Mr. Tory should come to party leaders and explain certain matters and say what his findings have been when a certain member might have been complained about. So there might be members who are experienced of that and those questions. The difficult cases have come to panels, which I've ended up chairing on three occasions, but to the most complicated cases. But I've not seen any analysis as to why things never got through and who were delays. I can think of lots of reasons, like difficulty in collecting evidence, people being unwilling to supply evidence because they're anxious, people being reassured that it's reasonable to give evidence and then coming forward. I can think of a situation perhaps where members said, well, I need to take some legal advice on this and have some outside advice before I can respond to this inquiry from the council. So I can see various things might have been built in or occurred, but what I was thinking of was a timeline that looked at particular cases saying this one didn't progress at that rate because of X, and that one didn't progress because of Y. I haven't seen that kind of analysis, which we seem to be missing out before we get to the suggestions before us.
Thank you, Chair. I'm talking a little bit about some of the history. I've been on the Standards Committee now for a number of years, through different municipal years. I've also been the subject, tied up today, of 15 standards complaints in my 18 years as a councillor. Going back to the standards board for England, every one of those 15 has been noted for that. A lot of complaints and progress. We've just dealt, the reason we called this was a recent complaint we had against the people today against Councillor Hayes, which stopped from the Normans for a amount of time. 11 months hanging up his head before it was resolved. Unbelievably. With the amount, the protocol being just thrown in the bin, basically, because nobody adhered to it, and this council officers or the investigating officer. I just made sent Mr. McCaws an email 2 weeks ago, asking him the updates for the status of a complaint made against me in November 2014. Mr. McCaws has no record of it, other than the complaint being made. I have a letter from Mr. Blott, dated September 2015, informing me that after 11 months, the case was now going to be investigated. After 11 months, they were now going to investigate this case, and then nothing. Mr. McCourt in dismissal, I was spoken to an independent person, determined that not being the public interest to carry on that complaint. But that's hung over me for 4 years, you know. And it was only complaining against Councillor Hayes because I forgot about 23. But then there's another one here. And then the reports Mr. Tork used to bring to us regularly showed 2 years, 2.5 years, 3 years. 18 months. It was just unbelievable the amount of time it would take. And I've looked at these new systems, new things, and you say they stick the same. But what they do, well, they give you the same get-out as well. Because if you look on page 30 of them, page 30, sent to last paragraph, says the London officer and blood receives complaint in 5 ways from the age of 8. A full copy of complaint, complaint was subject to any ruling or disclosure. Ordinarily, you sent a member of the complaint, I'll be advising their written comments within 10 working days. Great. But then, it says thereafter, arrangements will be assessed as soon as practical. It gives you the same get out. What is as soon as practical? 1 year, 2 years, 3 years? That needs to have a time scale. That, all these as soon as practical, or practicable, whatever you want to call it, need to be taken out. And there needs to be steps. Complaint received, acknowledged, subject matter informed, initial assessment, doesn't need investigation, closure. There needs to be no simple steps. There can be no, you know, can we have, well, we need another 3 months to look at this, so we haven't been able to appoint an investigative officer. It's not on. We have a responsibility as a committee to look after those members who, and members of the public who might make complaints, as well as the well-being of those subject members who are complaining against. And to allow these things to drift, as in my case for 4 years, is unacceptable.
Yes, Andrew. I was going to say this needs to be some sort of tracker, just like some sort of tracker where the, you know, any complaints are registered on particular time scales, that, you know, particular stages of the process should have happened, and if they haven't, an explanation why. And then somebody needs to look at that, don't they, to say where, you know what I mean, where kind of the time scales are falling down. I just wanted to ask a question. Is there a list of ongoing complaints, and do we know where they are all up to?
We have now put in place an electronic case management system to handle the complaints. At the current time, there is only one complaint that has only arrived this week that is ongoing. All of the complaints have been dealt with. And just in answer to Councillor Gilchrist, the number of cases that we looked at has been, I think it's approximately 58 cases since 2012, and we went through, I went through all of those cases, there are a very small number have actually come to the stage of being formally investigated and come to panel. The majority of them have been dealt with by local resolution. So in terms of those cases, the only actual timescales were the timescales, the initial timescales for acknowledging receipt of the complaint and notifying the member. So those were the factors that we looked at.
Okay, I'm really pleased to hear that piece of work's been done. I think we need some sort of system whereby, as I say, that is monitored, and then any exceptions are brought to the notice of the standards chair, for example, on a regular basis, so we can see what's on track, what's not, and for those that are on what the remedial action is.
Thanks, Chair. Again, just some questions for Mr. O'Connor. I think the first comment before we get to that is, I think